Okay, hello everybody. I am here to make you guys a cover. So these are the apps that you're gonna start with. Well, they're not the apps that you're gonna start with, but these are everything that I could ever use to make covers or any type of graphic. This is for manipulation, Pixlr, Fonto for font, photo layers for cutting, Ibis Paint X for painting, PixArt just for random stuff, and that's my gallery, my music, and, you know, when you need a thunderstorm, there's the rain app. Anyway, I apologize for any music you hear in the background. I need the music to play, or to work on this stuff. And I apologize for any cussing you may hear in the background. I'll try to change the song if that happens. Now, let's start with here. We're on Pixlr. You need to load. I already cut out all the images I'm gonna need for this. So, first, you need a background. Because you can't just have like a blank background on this. So, you need an actual background. I'm using the dimensions of 1920 by 3000. If you're using Pixlr, a way to make it so that it won't pixelate on you is to use a very large background as your template. So now, I'm just yellowing this so I don't know what I'm doing. So, I'm gonna pause the video until I find a nice background picture. Okay? If this will pause. Okay. Do not turn off the music. Okay, I found a nice cool background picture. Let's see, we're right here. All credits to my most of the stuff on here is in Deviant Art. I'll try to link it back if I can find the links that I found these things at. At least I'll try and find the username. So this is a nice image right here because you don't have to do a lot with it. You can just put it right there and the blackness fades right in. It's very nice. It's simple too. A tip is to keep it small because you want to see as much of the background column as possible. So these columns right here and right there on the edges, you want to see those because it makes it look cool and more big. Excuse my grammar. I don't grammar. It's already too late for this. Anyway. See, you don't have to, but you might want to feather off the bottom. You can use the doodle tool just to smooth it out, just in case you might have something to deal with it later. There. Now we can put in our model. I already cut her out using photo layer superimpose. So I suggest not cutting the person out very So see how she's like in striking contrast with this thing? That's not cool. We don't like that. So here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go out of this, out of Pixlr, and we're gonna go to Photo Layers House. Yeah, let's listen to that music while it loads. Okay. Anyway, we're back in photo layers. I'm gonna remove this layer because I just cut it out. And now you want to change the color, you want to change it to the background so it will save as a PNG. So, we go to here. We want it to match the background of that cover we currently have as closely as possible. So, first things first, that thing is very low saturation. So we take the saturation and turn it to almost nothing. Not completely nothing, but almost nothing. Like that. Now, it's blue. Hold on. It takes a minute for me to figure out because I don't do it all the time. Wait. Okay, screw what I said about the saturation for now. Because I think there's another way to do that, but let's... Okay. Go back to the saturation. I'm so sorry, guys. And then you want the tint. Nope. I don't know what I did here. It usually works. There, tint. There we go. So, if you can look at the bars, you can figure it out yourself. So there we go. Now let's go check to see how it fits with that other thing that we were doing. I bet you can probably hear an airplane in the background right now. I don't even know what's going on. See how it goes? Does it match? It matches pretty close, as you can see in this side-by-side comparison. Yes, that's Fall Out Boy playing in the background. So anyway, you save. You want to save it. Don't hit finish, because you might want to edit it some more. So. Okay, we come back here. Now, we go to the double exposure feature. Oh, it's like double exposure is your best friend. Especially for those of you who like to do man-ups, and we all love that man-ups. Load. And now, you have this. As you can see, it's pretty roughly cut out. Now, this is clashing. So, I'm gonna edit the background. So it's like... So that it is more... This isn't fitting very well, so I'm going to make zoom in on the background. Let's see if I can make it fast. Loading my gallery. Loading my gallery. Somebody needs to remind me to credit all the music in the background of this. No, just watch, you guys are probably gonna find it before I do. Yeah, oh, there it is. Okay, turn down the music. Yeah! Turning back up the music. Now I know you all want to listen to Fall Out Boy, but I'm gonna pause it right here. Yes, it will. Yeah! So, since our person in the image is kind of clashing, I'm seeing if it'll look a little better if I zoom the image. Let's see. Let's try it. See? Note that the floor is right here. You know how I just to thin it out. See, this should be the stuff in elevator music. Okay, we're trying to overlay. We want to get that saturation up. So we're going over here again. Because I messed up. We all mess up, we all make these mistakes. Just I'm tempted to make this cover orange, just so I can make it fit. Okay, let me readjust everything. See, this works actually rather well if I do it orange. Let's try it orange and do the other thing orange. No, I don't want to reach it right now. And now we need to have a Wi-Fi right now, if you have a noise. Of course we could try and just orange it right here. Colors are fun, they always are. We haven't even gotten to anything. And wonder what would happen if I just put the regular one. This one has an outline. And maybe that could work. Okay, this is gonna be a very rough cover. Now you don't want to do what I just did. And okay, you have that. Remember to lower the opacity just so it blends a little better. Made a mistake. Crap. Okay. Here. You see that ribbon coming down from her? Coming down from her arm. Well, you want to erase that because it looks bad. Let's put it down to 90 opacity, should be fine. I keep messing up. Hold on. I want to at least get this part finished in the video. I hate myself right now. And my music isn't playing. Hold on, let's fix that really. Okay, I know you guys don't want me to go through my music, but I can't do this without my music. So. Okay. So. It's quiet, so I can turn it up. This involves just a little bit of manipulation. Darn, I keep doing it. Now you take the eraser tool. We want to get her thing off. Because. But not the bottom of this cup. You want to keep that there. Because you see how it's not like blending very well? Because you can't blend it like that. You want the feather to be less. It doesn't have to be perfect. People won't notice unless they're professionals and we're not professionals. So take that off. Now that that's done, you want to overlay it again. This time using the different up as best as you can. Use that one. See, no one even notices. And here. Grab on with it. Let's move this. don't know if it's easier to line things up on Photoshop, but I'm gonna pretend. It's not lined up perfectly, but it's lined up closely enough that you may not notice. And then dark makes it just looks like to become less sleepy. Soft light looks the best, maybe it does not. Yeah. I'm going to end this video right here because I'm out of time. So, keep an eye out for part 2.